Hello student, let's start with our next remaining part of the third unit which was started in the previous week. So we are discussing about the third unit. The name of our unit is the language translator, and in this unit specifically we are focusing on the language translator, that is the compiler, and how the compiler process your source program using the different phases that we are discussing in this unit. And in the previous lecture already we have discussed the first phase of compiler, that is the lexical analyzer, in details how the lexical analyzer, that is the first phase of compiler, process your source program, how it will generate the tokens. Also during the designing phase of the compiler, when the compiler as a system program is getting designed and developed, how the lexical analysis phase get designed and the develop with the help of the regular expression, finite automata, etc. These things also we have discussed. So this is the general scenario, that what exactly mean by the phases of compiler, which also number of times we have discussed. So phases is nothing but the different stages in the processing of your source program by the compiler. And in the technical words, it is also being mentioned here. A phase is nothing but the logically interrelated operation, where each of the particular phase take the program in one particular form and represent that program as output in another form. So mainly there are the two main phases, analysis phase and the synthesis phase. Okay, and recently we are discussing about the analysis phase of compiler. So in the analysis phase, already I told you three main phases comes: lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and the semantic analysis. Already we have finished the lexical analysis with all the details and different terms related with that also, where you can see here each particular phase take the input in one particular form and produce the output in another form. Likewise, here you can see our first phase of compiler take the input in the form of some higher level language. And so what our first phase of compiler does, that is lexical analysis, and first phase of our compiler generate the tokens. That is the main role performed by our first phase of compiler, that is the tokens. Here you can see first phase of compiler, that is the lexical analyzer generating the token here, and that token is given as a input to the next phase of compiler, that is the syntax analyzer. And today we are going to discuss about this phase of compiler, that is the syntax analyzer. Okay. Likewise, each phase is having their different roles. Okay, step by step we will see that, just like we have seen in case of the lexical analyzer. So just as a recap, lexical analyzer we already studied, it read the input characters from your source program, and from that source program it try to generate the tokens. If the programmer written all the codes according to the rules, if the programmer has not used any illegal characters, if the programmer has not utilized any variable with the exceeding length, as well as if the programmer has not written any word within your source program with which the spelling of that particular word is incorrect, then in that case no lexical error will be generated. But if the programmer utilize illegal characters, then exceeding length of the characters, and if you have utilized the incorrect spelling, then different kind of lexical errors can be generated, that with the example I told you last time. So role of the lexical analyzer is nothing but the reading and scanning the entire source code of the program and generating the token one by one. So what we mean by the token, that also last time we have seen. So role of the scanner or the lexical analyzer is nothing but the production or generation of the token whenever the tokens are requested by the second phase of compiler, that is the parser, or that is also called as a syntax analyzer. So whenever this parser requests the token, here you can see lexical analyzer read the source program, generate the tokens, and send that token to the syntax analyzer. Okay. So from these we can say the main role being performed by the lexical analyzer is nothing but recognize and generation of tokens by reading the source program. So whenever the lexical analyzer read the source program, it divide that source program or break down the source program into the different pieces, into the different parts, and it check each of that part, whether that each of small part of your program, whether it is eligible to become the tokens or not. Now, which different sequence of character or part of your source program can become the tokens, for that different rules are being utilized. Already I told you what are mean by the rules or the patterns, which is being checked by the compiler. Okay, when you compile the program, compiler check whether your program and the different content of your program is following that particular patterns or the rules. For example, we are discussing regarding the rules related with the declaration of variable, etc. Okay, how that rule being mentioned, when that rule mentioned, that already we have discussed. These rules are being mentioned when the designing of our system program, that system program, that is our compiler, is taking place by the system programmer. Okay, so lexical analyzer, that is the first phase of compiler, break down or divide your source program to the different part, and it check each part whether it is eligible to become the token or not. So tokens is nothing but the class or category of your sequence of character or the lexeme. Like it can be identifier, it can be a keyword, it can be an operator, it can be a constant, etc. Okay, so while designing of the compiler is taking place, in that when the lexical analyzer is getting designed, the system programmer used to mention all the rules of formation of the tokens related to the particular language. And with the help of how the system programmer mentioned these all the rules related with the formation of tokens, with the help of the different regular expressions and the finite automata. Now, what exact role being played by this regular expression and finite automata, that last time already I told you. So when user compile his program, then the compiler, and in that first phase of compiler, just check whether user as a programmer who is writing the source program in any language, for example, user as a programmer writing the program in the C language. So compiler, and in that first phase of compiler, just check whether the programmer has written code according to the some predefined rules. Because when the compiler is getting designed, in that designing and developing, during that designing and development of the compiler, the system programmer used to mention some predefined rules there. Okay, with the help of some regular expression, finite automata, etc. Okay, and with the help of some code. So when user check its program during the compilation, or when the user compile his program using the compiler, so compiler just check whether user has written all the code according to the predefined rules or not. The same thing I have mentioned here. When user compile his program, compiler, and in that first phase of compiler, just check whether user programmer has written code according to the predefined rules. So predefined rules are nothing but rules which is defined by the system programmer while designing of the compiler. So if all rules are followed, then no error will be generated after the compilation. But if different if the all rules are followed, then no error will be get generated after compilation. But if rules are not followed, some predefined rules are not followed, means what? What is the predefined rules of declaring the variable in the C language? That variable should start with the letter. Okay, and after the letter, there can be a multiple letters, or there can be a digit, or you can also declare the variable using the single letter also. But if you want to utilize the multiple letter, you can also utilize the multiple letter, and after that you can also utilize the digit. That is the standard rule. That is a standard predefined rule. But you cannot start the variable with the digit and after that letter like this. Understood? So that is the predefined rule. So if you write the variable in your program like this, starting with the digit, then definitely the different lexical errors will start. And different the compiler will show the different lexical errors, like illegal characters are utilized. Okay. And while declaring the variable, if you utilize this kind of symbol, dollar, which is not allowed, which is considered as an illegal character while declaring the variable, then also it is not according to the predefined rules. So there also the compiler will show you the different lexical errors. So the same thing I have mentioned here. If all the rules are followed, then no error will be generated after the compilation. Otherwise, different lexical error can be generated, like illegal character use, misspelling, exceeding length of identifier, etc., etc. Okay, so these things has to be followed, and then only the compiler will not show you any error. Otherwise, predefined rules are not followed, definitely the compiler will show the different kind of lexical errors. Okay, now let's see the one more example related with the lexical analyzer, and try to see how the lexical analyzer will process that particular sentence or the string. Okay, in the first phase. Now, same example we are going to consider for the second phase of our compiler, that is the syntax analyzer also. First, let's discuss how the lexical analyzer will process such kind of string. Now, in the exam also, you will get such kind of string, and you will be asked how the first phase of compiler, that is the lexical analyzer, will process this sentence or the string. Now, I already told you during each phase, there is a utilization of symbol table generation start during the first phase of compiler. Okay. Now, if there is a such kind of sentence in your source program, so for that symbol table get generated, like serial number, variable name, and the variable type. So here we are considering variable type of all these variable, like X, A, B is float. Okay. So variables are, which are variables in this program, X, A, B are the variables, and its type we are considering as a float. Okay. So lexical analyzer first generate the table. Okay. And make the entry of different symbols, which is part of your source program there. Then lexical analyzer, how actually process this your program or content of your source program. So yeah, we are just considering the single statement here. So lexical analyzer will break down or divide this sentence into the different parts, into the single parts. Okay. So X is a one part of the statement, equal to assignment operator is a one part. Then A is another part, plus is another part, B is another part, and star is another part, and 50 is another part. So this whole statement is divided into the separate part by the lexical analyzer. That is the one of the role being played by the lexical analyzer. So each of these being considered as a lexeme if they match with the patterns. Okay. So role of the lexical analyzer is what? To check all these separate parts of this statement, check with the rules, check with the patterns. Means what? Whether X is a identifier or whether X is a variable or not, that is checked by whom? Lexical analyzer. If X is following all the patterns or the rules of formation of the variable, all the predefined rules, if followed by the X, then X will be declared as a token. Okay, X will be declared as a token as a identifier. Okay, and here it can be written like this also, ID, comma 1, means first identifier. Then same, this assignment operator is also check against the predefined rule. If it is following predefined rule, then it will be also declared as a token operator. Okay, of type assignment. Same, A is also check against the predefined rule. If it is following the predefined rules of formation of the identifier or the variable, if it is matching the patterns or the rules, then it will be also declared as a identifier, as a token. So here it can be written like ID, comma 2, second identifier. Same case for this operator, same case for the third identifier, it can be written like this. Same case for the star operator, and same case for the plus. So these are nothing but the tokens. Okay, these are nothing but all the tokens, class or category of lexeme which is present in your program. Now, which lexemes present in your program? X equal to A plus B, these are all considered as a lexeme. Okay, and if this lexeme matching with the patterns, then they can be considered as a tokens. Okay, so this sequence of character, if this sequence of character match with the pattern, then they will consider as a lexeme. And what is the class or category of this lexeme? These are the class or category of this lexeme, like identifier, operator, etc. And class or category of lexeme is considered as what? The tokens. So in this way, you can see role of the lexical analyzer is nothing but generation and recognition of these different kind of tokens. So these tokens are being generated for this particular expression. So if your source program consists of thousands of lines, then for each of these lines, for each of these lines get divided into or break down into the separate by the into the separate parts by the lexical analyzer, and then lexical analyzer will identify the token out of that. So if all the things which you have written in the program is following the rules of formation of the tokens, then no lexical error will be generated. But if the content of your source program not following the rules of formation of the tokens, then definitely the different lexical error will be generated. Okay, so from this we get the final tokenized expression. So we can write the tokenized expression like this also: id comma 1 means first identifier equal to the second identifier plus third identifier or the variable into the 50. So to the variable you can call the identifier also, or it can be represented like this: id 1 op, id 2 op, id 3 op, 50 op in the sense operator. Okay, so this is nothing but the output. This is the output generated by the first phase of our compiler, that is the lexical analyzer. Okay, and this output will be given to the second phase of compiler that we are going to discuss now. Okay, so this is our second phase of compiler that you can see. Okay, second phase of compiler that you can see. Now this is the block diagram where also I have shown you. So source program given as a input to the first phase of compiler. So our first phase of compiler is the lexical analysis. Okay, then now when the lexical analyzer will generate the token, when second phase of compiler, that is second phase of compiler, is also called as a syntax analyzer, and it can also be called as a parser. So when our second phase of compiler request to the first phase for the tokens, then lexical analyzer will read the source program, generate the tokens, identify the tokens, and it send it to the second phase of compiler, that is the parser here. And here you can see what exactly role being played by the parser or the syntax analyzer. So syntax analyzer generate the parse tree, and then again syntax analyzer send this parse tree to the third phase of compiler that next time we will discuss. Okay, here just concentrate on what is the output being produced by the lexical analyzer, that is the token. An output produced by the second phase of compiler, that is the syntax analyzer or the parser, is the parse tree. Okay, now what do you mean by the generation of parse tree? What exactly it is that we'll see. Just keep in mind here, our second phase of compiler produced the output as what? Parse tree. Okay, now second phase name here you can see is the syntax analysis. What? Syntax analysis. Now just like we have discussed, the first phase role is generation of the tokens. So here syntax analysis role is nothing but the check the syntax. Now when you write the source program, in that source program you write the different statements. Like for example, you write the statement like int a comma b like this. Now is this the correct syntax of declaration of variable using the data type int? No, because this statement should be ended by the semicolon. If you don't write the semicolon here, what kind of error you will get? Definitely the kind of error you will get, that is the syntax error. Because you are not following here the correct structure of writing the sentence, the correct structure of writing the particular declaration of variable using the data type int. So checking the syntax of your statement, which you are writing in your source program, checking the syntax or structure or correct format of writing the sentence in your source program, that is nothing but the work or main role performed by the syntax analysis, simply checking the syntax. Okay, now here I have taken the one general life example. Here you can read, I have mentioned the statement, he boy is intelligent. Now is this syntactically correct statement? Is this syntactically correct English language statement? No, because in the English language we follow the some structure, some grammatical rules. Like what grammatical rules? While you are speaking the English language statement, and how you speak the English language statement, while speaking or while writing the English language statement, you follow some rules like subject plus verb plus object, like this kind of syntactical structure or sentence format you used to follow. Now here is this, now this is the general structure of writing the English language statement. Now in this statement, is this rules is being getting followed? No. Actually, what I am trying to say, he is a boy. what he is a boy and is intelligent, but I have written it incorrectly. So this is not the syntactically correct English language statement. What? This is not the correct syntactical statement, because here I have not followed the rules. Subject is he. Okay, after the subject there must be a verb, that is, but after the he I have written the object, that is a boy. Understood? So correct statement should be like this: he is a boy, like this, and is intelligent, like this. Okay, so during, as you can say, English language, during speaking the English language statement also we have to follow some grammatical rules. If you don't follow, then that statement will not be considered as a syntactically correct statement. Okay, and same thing is there in case of higher level language also. When you are writing some sentence in the higher level language, if you don't follow the syntax, then definitely you will get the kind of error that is the syntactical errors. Now, which are the different syntactic errors that we'll see, but here just you keep in mind what is the concept of syntax analysis. So concept of syntax analysis, or role of the syntax analysis, is what? To check whether the sentence is being written according to the syntax or not. Whether the particular sentence, for example, you are writing the C programming sentence, whether it is right according to the rules, or whether that sentence is right in the correct format, whether that sentence is right in the correct structure or not, that is the work of syntax analyzer. Now, how the syntax analyzer does it? So for that syntax analyzer, what it does for particular sentence, the syntax analyzer used to generate the parse tree. Okay, and if the parse tree is generated correctly, then there is no syntactical errors. Okay, but if the parse tree is not generated, then there is a presence of the syntactical error is considered. Now question arises, how the parser or the syntax analyzer generate the parse tree? Okay, now syntax analyzer or the parser generate the parse tree with the help of the grammar. What? With the help of the grammar. Just like in the English language statement I told you, we used to write the English language statement, or we used to speak the English language statement by following the grammar. So in case of the higher level language also, there is also utilization of grammar, and with the help of the grammar, syntax of the sentence is checked. So in case of the higher level language, you should keep in mind, we used to utilize which kind of grammar? CFG. Context-free grammar is utilized in case of the syntax analysis. And if the sentence which you have written in your source program, if that sentence is according to the context-free grammar, then you will not get any error. But if sentence which you have written, these are not according to the context-free grammar, then you definitely get the syntactical errors. Okay. So when these things are being defined, just like in the lexical analyzer, I told you, during the designing of the first phase of compiler, all the rules are mentioned regarding formation of the tokens. Okay, consider this as a designing of the compiler. In that, okay, in the first phase I already told you, regarding the formation of the tokens, all the rules are mentioned. In the similar way, during the designing of second phase of compiler, okay, during the designing of second phase of compiler, that is the syntax analyzer, there also the system programmer also need to specify all the grammatical rules. Okay, here while the designing of second phase of compiler, that is the syntax analysis, the system programmer who is designing the compiler has to mention all the predefined rules here, all the predefined grammatical rules here. Means what? Suppose, as I said, if I write the statement like this, int a, and after the a you don't write anything, then this statement should give the syntax error like there is a no presence of termination symbol, there is no presence of semicolon. Now, how the compiler will give you this kind of errors when you writing the source program and you write this statement in the source program, how the compiler will give the error? Compiler will give you the error because when the compiler is getting designed, all these predefined rules are mentioned here. For regarding this statement, the predefined rule is mentioned is like what? If you declare some variable, that variable should be terminated by the semicolon. This sentence should be terminated by the semicolon. So all these rules are being predefinedly mentioned when the designing of compiler is taking place, specifically when the designing of second phase of compiler is taking place. And when you compile the program, compiler check whether while writing the sentence, whether the programmer has followed the syntactical rules of writing the sentence or not. If the programmer has not followed the rules of writing the sentence, if the programmer has not followed the syntactic rules of writing the sentence, then definitely you will get the different syntactical errors. Okay. So during the designing of compiler and the second phase of compiler, all the rules, grammatical rules are being mentioned, because syntax analysis does the syntax analyzer does the syntax analysis or syntax analyzer does the checking of syntax only basis of what? Only basis of grammar. And these grammatical rules are already being mentioned in the compiler when the designing of compiler is taking place. When you compile the program, the compiler just does the task of matching the source program with the predefined rules of grammar. Okay. So here I have mentioned the same thing. Syntax analysis is the second phase of compilation process. It takes the tokens as an input and generates the parse tree as output. Okay. So what the syntax analyzer does, you can see here, it receives the tokens from first phase of compiler, and then it combines that tokens, and from that it will form the sentence and check whether that sentence is syntactically correct or not. Okay. So syntax analyzer or the parser use the output of the first phase as an input to itself, and from that tokens it try to form a sentence, and if that sentence is and after formation of sentence, it check whether that sentence is syntactically correct or not with the help of the generation of parse tree. Okay. So in syntax analysis phase, the parser check that expression made by the tokens, means the expression or the sentence which is being generated with the help of the different tokens is syntactically correct or not. Okay. So role of syntax analyzer is just restricted to check the syntax. Now, whether that particular content of your source program, it is having the correct tokens or not, that role is performed by the lexical analyzer. Okay. So in this syntax analysis phase, we'll simply check syntax after the tokenizing the expression, means after the formation of expression with the help of the tokens. Okay. Now, so here the concluding point. So here we can see the conclusion from this slide, that exactly role being played by the syntax analyzer is nothing but what? To receive the tokens from lexical analyzer and then combine these token, and after combining this token, check whether that combined token sentence is syntactically correct or not. And how the syntax analyzer check it? By generation of parse tree for that particular sentence. Okay. So parser or the syntax analyzer get the token, combine that token, from that tokens it will form particular expression or the sentence, and after formation of expression or sentence, syntax analyzer will try to generate the parse tree. If the parse tree is generated, it means syntax is correct. If the parse tree is not generated, it means syntax is incorrect. Okay. Now, so in brief, this point I have mentioned here, the syntax analysis are all about checking the structure in your source code, and it determines whether or not sentence or the string follow the expected format, or whether sentence or the string which is being formed by combining the tokens, whether that sentence or the string is following the correct format or not. So the main aim of this phase is to make sure that the source code was written by the programmer is syntactically correct, okay, or not. So syntax analysis is a rule based, just like lexical analysis also the rule based, okay. And with the help of grammatical rules, the syntax analyzer try to construct the parse tree. Okay, with the help of the combined tokens. And if the parse tree can be generated, it means there is a no error, syntactical error. If not, then there is a different kind of syntactic errors may be present. Okay. So main role is nothing but to check or determine whether the source language or the syntax of the source language which are being written by the user or the programmer is according to the grammar or not. Okay, different sentences, statement you have written in the program, whether it is, whether these are according to the grammar or not. Okay. Now, in case of the higher level language, which kind of grammar is utilized? Context free grammars. Okay. Now, so from the discussion, we can list out the task performed by the second phase of compiler, that is syntax analyzer. The different tasks are like obtain the tokens from the lexical analyzer, get the tokens from lexical analyzer, and then check if the expression is syntactically correct or not. After getting the tokens, that tokens will combine together and from that expression will be formed, and role of the syntax analyzer to check whether that expression is syntactically correct or not. If there are any syntactical errors, then report that syntax errors. Okay. And construction of the parse tree for the particular that expression or the sentence. If the parse tree is generated correctly, then no syntactic error. If not, then presence of the syntax error will be there. So now point is, which are the different syntactical error can be? Okay, so during the syntax analysis phase, this different kind of syntactical errors generally encounters or appears. And so syntax error get generated generally when the programmer or the coder who is writing the code or the program not follow the correct syntax while writing the programming language sentence in the source program. Okay. So if the programmer write all the sentences with the according to the format, according to the structure, then there will be the no syntactical errors. So the here I have mentioned some of the basic syntax errors. Okay. Some of the basic syntax error like error in the structure of the sentence, means error in the format of the sentence, missing the operators, unbalanced parentheses, like these are the different kind of syntactical errors. So with the example, we will just see. Now, for example, here I have written one particular fragment of code. Now, with the line number I have mentioned here. So in this, here you can see I have written if and in bracket number. And here I have mentioned one operator equal to, okay, this operator. Now, this operator is actually the assignment operator. Which kind of operator is this? This is the assignment operator. Okay, assignment operator and 200. Now, when you compile the program by writing such kind of code, the compiler will display you the different kind of warnings and the errors. So definitely the one syntax warning will be displayed. And that syntax warning will be like this. Assignment operator is used in the line number 16 of the program. Now here assignment operator is not expected. Here which kind of operator is expected? This equality operator is expected there. Okay, but the programmer, if the programmer write it like this, then definitely the warning will be displayed. Because in this code, if the expression used with the equal sign, which is actually the assignment operator, but which operator is expected there? This kind of operator. So in case of this kind of writing the code, the syntax error may be come. Okay. Then, so same thing I have mentioned. So if the programmer utilize this kind of operator instead of this kind of operator, then definitely the error will come. Okay. Now, so correct way of writing that sentence will be like this: if number and then equality operator equal to the 200. This is the correct way of writing the if statement there. Okay. Then if you see the second kind of syntactical error example, that is the missing semicolon. Okay, missing semicolon. You can see if the programmer write the sentence like int a equal to 5. Now this sentence after the 5, there must be a semicolon. Okay, according to the correct syntax. Okay, for example, C language. So here, if there is a no presence of semicolon, then definitely compiler message will show you expected semicolon there. Understood. And this kind of error will be shown by the compiler when the user compile the program or the programmer compile the program. So regarding that, here there is a expected semicolon. These rules are already mentioned. When the designing of compiler is taking place, these rules are already being mentioned. These grammatical rules are already being mentioned when the designing of the compiler is taking place by the system programmer. So when user compile his source program, okay, when the user writes some source program and try to compile the source program, the compiler simply try to match the user source program with the predefined rules. If the user program doesn't match with the predefined rules, then different kind of such kind of syntactical errors can be get displayed and announced. Now, third kind of error also I have mentioned here. Now, here you can see this is the expression written by the programmer. Now, here the programmer has not closed this particular sentence by the closing parenthesis. Expected is what this kind of thing here. So, in case of programmer writes such kind of sentence, missing parenthesis error can also be displayed. That is also come under the category of syntactical errors. Okay. Now again missing argument error can also come like this. If the programmer write the sentence like y is equal to 3 plus, now 3 plus and star. Now between the plus and star, there is a need of some kind of what we can say argument, variable, or some value is needed between this plus and star operator. Okay, so this in case of such kind of writing the program sentence, missing argument error can be come. So these are the different kind of syntactical errors that might come if the predefined rules of writing the program is not followed. Okay. And who is doing all this task? Our second phase of compiler, that is the syntax analysis. Okay. Now, let's see the example that we have seen while we are just discussed previously, the lexical analyzer, and with the help of the lexical analyzer, we have processed one sentence. Okay. So from this discussion, we can make the summary that syntax analyzer checks whether sentence or the string is grammatically correct or not. And as I said, syntax analyzer generates the parse tree. If the parse tree can be generated successfully, then it announces the syntax is correct. If the parse tree is not get generated, then it announces it as a syntactical error. So here we are taking the same example that we have processed while lexical analysis. X is equal to a plus b into 50. Now, whether this x is a token, this assignment operator is token, a is token, b, whether these different parts of sentence, whether they are forming the tokens or not, that task is performed by the lexical analyzer. Okay. And then lexical analyzer send these tokens to the syntax analyzer. So syntax analyzer will combine these tokens, and from this it will try to generate the parse. Now here, we are taking the same example, x is equal to a plus b into 50. Okay. And we have given, as I said, syntax analyzer does the syntax analysis or the parsing by utilizing the grammar. So here, some predefined grammar we are taking. So this is some predefined grammar is given. Okay. Now these grammars already being mentioned when the designing of compiler is taking place. So when user compile the program, user program just get check against such kind of grammar. Okay. So such, we are just trying to demonstrate it, how this sentence, for this sentence, how the syntax will be check and how the parse tree will be get generated. So x equal to a plus b into 50. Now this grammar is given, and from this we have to check whether this sentence is syntactically correct or not. So for this sentence, the parse tree will be generated like this. Okay. So here the parsing or the syntax analysis will start with the starting symbol. So here grammar is given starting symbol S, derives ID equal to E. So we'll start with the starting symbol S, deriving ID equal to E. So this ID is our first ID equal to E, E as an expression. Okay. Then after that, now we have to focus on this expression also while you are generating the parse tree for this kind of expression using the grammar. So now we have got the equal to operator here. Okay. Now this ID comma one is actually nothing but the X. ID one is nothing but what? X. While tokenizing the expression, we have seen lexical analyzer has considered this X as a ID one. Okay. Lexical analyzer considered this X as a ID one. So while generating the parse tree, also we have to consider this as a ID one, which is nothing but our X. Now next is what? Now E, Now we have got the equal to operator. Next is we have to derive this string. We have to generate this string in the parse tree. We have to generate the parse tree for this string a plus b into 50. So which production rule can be utilized? We can utilize this production rule, e is equal to e plus t. So e is equal to e plus t. That is the expression deriving the expression plus term. So then here this rule we have written. Then what is the expression? Expression can be a term. Here you can see the expression can be a term. Term can be a factor. Term can be a factor, and factor can be a identifier. Now this is our second identifier, is nothing but which you have to consider it as a. Okay, because while the lexical analyzer has tokenized the expression, it has declared this a as a second ID. Okay, then same. Now we have got the x equal to a. We have got the plus. Now we want to get the second. We want to get the next identifier. So then again we see in the grammar which production rule you can utilize to get the next part of this string b into 50. So we can utilize the third production rule here. So third production rule is what term derives the term into the factor. So term in deriving the term into the factor. What is the term? Term is the factor. Factor is what again? Factor is deriving the ID. So here you got the third ID. So this you have to consider it as a b. Okay. And then now what we have got, x is equal to a plus b. And we have got this operator also into. Now f is what? F is deriving the integer constant. So here we derive it as integer constant. And what exactly it is in our expression? That is the 50. So here you can see for this expression, using this grammar, the particular parse tree is getting generated. It means this particular sentence is syntactically correct. This particular sentence is syntactically correct. So if from the particular grammar, the parse tree or the syntax tree is generated, then it means the syntax of that particular sentence or the expression is correct. And in this way, the syntax analyzer will check the syntax of all the expression, all the sentence which is present in the source program. And if all the sentences and expression for all the sentences and expression parse tree generated, then the syntax analyzer will not give you any kind of error. If the parse tree is not generated, then it will definitely show you the different kind of syntactical errors. So out of this, we can make the summary. The main role performed by the syntax analyzer is nothing but what? To receive the tokens from lexical analyzer and check whether the syntactically correct sentence can be formed or generated from that token. So syntax analyzer requests the token from lexical analyzer and it try to check the syntax. Okay, by generating the parse tree. So while designing the compiler is taking place, and in that when the designing of the syntax analyzer is taking place, the system programmer used to mention all the rules of formation of syntactically correct sentence of particular language with the help of the grammars. So when user compile his program, the compiler, and in that second phase of compiler, just check whether the user as a programmer has written code according to the predefined syntactical rules, the rules which is defined by the programmer while designing of the second phase of compiler, that is the grammatical rules. Okay. So if all the grammatical rules were followed, then no error will be come after the compilation. But grammatical rules are not followed by the source programmer. In that case, different syntax error can be generated, like missing semicolon, missing parentheses, missing arguments. These different kind of syntax error can be generated. Okay, so that's it regarding the second phase of compiler, that is the syntax analysis. Okay, who is generating the parse? Now, whatever the output generated by the parse tree, that will be sent to the next phase of compiler. Okay, and what is our next phase of compiler? You can see here, our next phase of compiler is nothing but the semantic analysis. Okay, that we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, so just go through this lecture once again and see if you have any doubt. You can comment your doubt in the comment section. Okay, I will definitely answer all the doubts. Okay, thank you all of you.